Hello, my name is David Faure and I work for KDAB. Many web services use a protocol called REST to interact with clients. REST is simply JSON over HTTP, and I'm going to show you how to implement a REST client in Qt using QJSonDocument and QNetworkAccessManager. I wrote an open source library that interacts with a web service called TMDB, which is all about movies. It's a movie database. We can ask it for a movie by name, let's say Office Space, and then we can ask for the actors in that movie and so on. You can find the link in the description to that open source library I wrote called libqtmdb. The first step when implementing a REST client is to look up, obviously, the documentation from the server about the calls that we can make. In the case of TMDB, it has this nice web page that tells us at this point here, api.moviedb.org/3, that's the version number of the API, you have to call slash configuration to get a number of configuration values, and it will tell us what is the expected input. For instance, in this case, the only thing that it expects as input is the API key, which represents the implementation of a client. It's just a way for them to know who's calling, basically. And we can click on try it out, and it shows us here that actually the input parameters will be passed into the URL itself as query items. So we can see here that we want to call this URL, and it has a query item called API key, and the value will be whatever the key value is. Okay, that gives us a URL we can use in QNetwork Access Manager to actually make the call. Okay, so this is the code of the library that I wrote. And what's interesting here is the constructor of that API class, which is the main entry point for the service. We pass it the API key. And the first thing we are going to do is take a base URL, which is api.tmdb/3, and the API key as a query item, because that's the base for any request that we want to make. But the first request that we have to make is the configuration call, as we saw in the web documentation. So we add slash configuration to the path, and that gives us the URL that we want to call. And we can then pass that to QNetwork request, which is what we can then give to the network access manager to do a get on that URL. And you see that QNAM is the QNetwork Access Manager instance. Okay, so we call get. What this does is that it returns a QNetwork reply, which is an object that will emit signals when the reply is available. This allows us to do everything asynchronously, which is quite nice in the GUI thread. So we connect to the finished signal, and we end up in the slot here, where we can first handle errors, and if there was no error, we read everything, and what we are reading is the JSON reply from the server, which we can then pass as JSON using QJSonDocument from JSON, get the object, which is a key value map, and you know whatever the code has to do with this, we load the configuration. So this was basically the initialization call. So this is internal to that API class. But for everything else, the application will want to do things like a request for a movie by name. And that's what's done in the method search movie here. When the application wants to search a movie by name, it will call search movie, which returns a job class. Job classes are a very common pattern for asynchronous APIs, where we make a request and we wait for the response, and the job class will contain the response for us. Basically, QNetwork reply is a job in this sense. And for your own classes, I recommend making jobs as well for all these asynchronous calls that you want to make. So if we have a look at the search job, we can see that it will emit the result signal whenever the result is available. And at that point, we can call the search result signal, the search result method, which contains all the data that we want. And it also has support for errors, of course. And if we have a look at what that looks like, search. So the constructor for search job will take the base URL, add the name of the object that we want to call in. So this is basically the method name, and set all the parameters, and again connect to use QNetwork Access Manager, create a request, connect to the reply. The same dance as what we did for the configuration. So all of your jobs can do that. And then you can use these jobs in your application. If you use them from the main thread, it's quite obvious. You'll just connect to the result signal. What if you want to unit test them? Let me show you what we do here in the unit tests for this one. In test search, we call the method that creates the job. And then to be able to wait for the signal to be emitted, you can create a signal spy on that signal. And then you can use the wait method that I added in Qt 5. So by now, everyone should have it, which allows to run the event loop until the signal is emitted, or after a timeout, it will error and say, okay, this wasn't emitted, so I have to give up. So there is a default timeout of 5 seconds, but you can set it to something else if you prefer. Okay, so this is how we can build everything using asynchronous APIs and the job pattern, but we can still very easily unit test it without the need for any slot. We just use qsignalspy_wait to wait for the result. Thank you for watching, and now it's time to take a rest. Or you could watch the next video, which will be all about SOAP. See you then.